The accusation against Harvey Weinstein have already cost him his career. Could cost him hundreds of millions of dollars as well.
The sale of the Weinstein Company could be in jeopardy after a lawsuit filed by New York's Attorney General.
Joining us now to talk more about this story is Attorney Debra Opri. Debra, thank you for being here.
Thanks. My
summation so far from what happened with the New York Attorney General is Harvey Weinstein is a rich guy, and they want to stop a super rich guy from becoming a mega super rich guy and profiting off the sale of his company. Is that what you see? Is that what's happening here?
Harvey is a wealthy guy who is soon to be in deep financial trouble, and possible orange pantsuits will be his designer wear. We have a PPSM moment. It's a pervasive pattern of sexual misconduct. There's complicity. We spoke about this a few minutes ago. And when you have a complicit nature of how businesses are being run, especially the Weinstein Company, you have an AG who says it's going to be a plethora of settlement discussions and we're going to tie up their money. That's why they filed the lawsuit when they did now, before it gets sold.
So the sale is essentially stopped, and it really comes down to compensation for the victims.
It comes down to monies that will be held as potential compensation for the victims. But remember, you meet a lot of lawyers involved. There's going to be a lot of time that passes. And this case is going to get ugly. When you look at the sale of the company is going to get sold. The name will probably get changed. But the new buyers, they don't want to buy something where they have to indemnify and assume the liability. So the AG is jumping in now to say, you want to sell the company? Sell the company. But whatever monies you're getting, they're going to go into a special fund pending litigation.
Okay. So they don't want Harvey Weinstein. That's good. They don't want Harvey Weinstein getting rich off of the sale and profiting. They also went out of their way, the Attorney General, to say they also don't want his enablers to profit from this as well. Although I would say, this is just my opinion, but some of his enablers would also be victims of his assistants that had his ED medication at the ready and, pardon their children watching, cleaned up after him. I wouldn't consider that person an enabler. I'd say that's also a victim, too.
But I wouldn't go that far. When you look at the sale of the company, you're not looking at people who are going to lose their jobs. These people will stay with whatever owners are coming in, unless there's going to be a change of what they're doing in terms of the company. But when you look at the corporate board of directors and the key shareholders, these are the people, and again, we talked about complicity. If they're complicit in having enabled him, I mean, remember the condoms and the whatever else for the erectile dysfunction right. issues in the limos. I mean, these were drivers that were hired by the company. People knew in the company at the hierarchy, they knew what he was doing. This is the enabling. This is the complicity. This is where the big dollars are going to be taken, because it's the board of directors and the company hierarchy that said, we know what you're doing, let's just keep it quiet.
So you're saying then that it's the manager's responsibility to report such bad behavior?
It is the corporate hierarchy that ran the show. The board of directors can't plead ignorance. You know, they had settlements.
Okay. Now that this lawsuit has been filed, what's next? Is this an easy case?
It's the beginning of the end of the company as we knew it. Whoever is buying that company, they will pay the sums. They are not going to buy a company subject to them assuming the liability. That has to get cleaned up. So here's the next thing that we have to start looking for. This will be for further future interviews. It may be the AG of New York who's filing this under the civil rights discrimination. But what about the private lawsuits that are coming? The floodgates are open. So if the money's going into a fund, who does that fund service? That's the question.
Can I read something to you?
Sure.
Harvey Weinstein's lawyer responded to the New York State, the Attorney General with this, and I'm just going to read it. Pardon me for looking out for a moment. Mr. Weinstein's behavior was not without fault. There certainly was no criminality, though. At the end of the inquiry, it will be clear that Harvey Weinstein promoted more women to key executive positions than any other industry leader. There was no discrimination at either Miramax or the Weinstein Company. That makes it sound, this is Harvey Weinstein's attorney, that Harvey Weinstein is actually a champion for women, if you
don't
listen to that.
You listen. That's puffery. When you look at what he is accused of, what he is allegedly, what he had been doing, you have to see a pervasive pattern of sexual misconduct. You don't promote women by going into their hotel room and allegedly raping them. You don't say, do this for me or you have no career. That's not promoting women. That's victimizing and using them. And I feel very strongly about that. These women were victims.
Countless, several dozens. All right, Debra Opri, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Thanks.